Hey y'all, it's me, it's your girl, and you already know. Like, share, and subscribe. What's up, real deal? And welcome to the channel. Hope everybody doing all right. I hope they going, you know, we got rain in Georgia due to the sun being so hot, y'all. And staying positive. Now we want to get into Breaja Terrell Mothers Testify. This is important in the case because she knew that her daughter went over to over to her son's father's house. Let's take a look.
Your attention to States Exhibit 95-1 and 95-2. For purposes of the record, what is this exhibit?
A work schedule for work.
Okay. Does this set forth your work schedule for July 9th and July 10th?
Yes, it does.
Okay. Now, on States Exhibit 95-1, does it indicate what had been your scheduled shift before changes were made?
Yes, ma'am.
And then going into 95.2, does it actually show the hours that you would have worked on July 9th and July 10th?
Yes.
Your Honor, at this time, the state would move to introduce States Exhibit 95-1 and 95-2.
Those exhibits will be admitted.
Okay. On States Exhibit 95-1, left-hand column.
That's the names of the employees.
call up for what was your original work schedule for July 10th?
It was for 11 a.m. to 4 p.m.
All right. Going to State's Exhibit 95-2 then for July 9th of 2020, does it set forth the times that you would have clocked in and clocked out?
Yes.
Okay, what time did you initially clock in on July 9th?
I clocked in originally at 10:39 a.m.
What time did you clock out?
I clocked out at 12:59 p.m.
Did you have a lunch break at that point in time?
Yes, I did.
And then what time did you clock in after your lunch break?
I clocked back in at 1:33 p.m.
And then what time did you clock out on July 9th of 2020?
I clocked out at 5:07.
Okay. And then so from that, did your trip over to the apartment complex occur within, you know, an hour or so later?
Yes.
Okay. Now, on July 10th, what does it show as a time that you actually clocked in at?
It says that I clocked in at 8:04 a.m.
What time did you clock out?
I clocked out at 8:16 a.m.
I want to pick up at the point in time where you described sitting in the back room and you were crying. There are checkers. What did your manager encourage you to do?
He encouraged me to get into the car and go downtown and figure out what was going on.
By going downtown, what do you mean?
Like going down to the police department.
Did you actually leave Checkers to travel down to the Davenport Police Department?
I did.
All right. When you left Checkers, what direction did you head to go downtown to the Davenport Police Department?
I was headed west. I was heading away.
On what street?
On Locust.
As you were traveling west on Locust, did you notice something of interest to you?
Yes, I did.
Describe.
I noticed Mr. Jenkins and Paula flying down the opposite way, making a really hard turn on, I think it's a left turn on Eastern.
What type of vehicle was he driving?
He was driving in a maroon and Paula went to Kansas.
And then did you pass him when you saw him heading east?
Yes.
What did you do?
I made a U-turn.
And then at that point in time, describe what you did.
I was behind him, honking the horn. I was calling his phone. And when I finally got him on the phone, he said that he was headed to Jersey Meadows because they wanted to talk to him up there. I was still on this bumper honking the horn that we had pulled over by the McDonald's on Northwest. It's like Kimberly, East Kimberly, across the street from Walgreens by the old Capitol.
All right. How would you describe the rate of speed that Mr. Dinkins was traveling?
I was probably going about 65, 70 possibly because he's driving really fast.
All right. Going back to State's Exhibit 38. My question to you is this. Do you see